Okay, Michael, so here's the little trick. So all I've done is I have replaced the equation at the top with an alternate version of the equation.
Okay. And it looks like you're now exponentially blowing up the reward.
Ah, I am not exponentially blowing up the reward. Instead, what I've done is I've added up the rewards that I'm going to see for the states that I'm going to see, and I multiplied it by gamma to the t, but gamma is between 0 and 1.
Ah, I see. So,
do you?
Well, kind of. So it doesn't exponentially blow up. It exponentially implodes.
Right.
So things that are like 1,000 steps in the future, if we take something that's less than 1 and we raise it to that power, it goes essentially to 0. So it's like it starts off, the rewards are kind of substantial, and then they trail off quickly.
Right. And in fact, we can write down mathematically what this is. You actually, if you stared at it long enough and you remembered your intermediate algebra or your calculus or wherever it is you learned this stuff, you would probably recognize this as a special kind of sequence or series. Do you remember what it is?
Television series?
No, but that's remarkably close. So let's see if we can bound this particular equation. So we know that this version of the equation eventually ends up being infinity if all the rewards are positive, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what does this end up being even in the case where all the rewards are positive? Well, we can bound this from above by the largest reward that we will ever see in the following way. So all I've done is said, well, I don't know what the rewards are, but there is some maximum reward. I'm going to call it R max. And if I pretended that I always got the R max reward, as long as that's an actual number, a finite number, I know that this is bounded from above by this expression.
Mm.
Well, what does this look like? Maybe this does look like a series you remember.
Geometric series?
Yes, this is the geometric series. And this is exactly equal to this.
And I assume that the summation causes the max to become lowercase?
Yes, it does. That's a trick that they don't really go over deeply in calculus, but it's true.
Oh, that's cool. All right, so the reward, the maximum reward, divided by 1 minus gamma. So when gamma is really close to 0, you're getting just that one reward in the beginning, and then everything falls off to nothing after that.
Yep.
And if gamma is really close to 1, you're dividing by something that's teeny tiny, which actually is like multiplying it by something that's really big. So it kind of magnifies the reward out. But it's not infinity until gamma gets all the way up to 1, and that's the same case we were in before.
Right. So in fact, you'll notice the way I wrote this, gamma has to be between 0 and 1, 0 inclusive, but strictly less than 1. If I made it so that it could include 1, well, that's actually the first case.
Got it.
Because 1 to a power is always 1, and so this is actually a generalization of the sort of infinite sum of rewards. This is called discounted rewards, or discounted series, or discounted sums. And it allows us, it turns out, to go an infinite distance in finite time.
Wait.
That makes sense.
No.
Well, it does.
An infinite distance?
Yeah, that's at least the way I like to think about it. So if we're discounted in this particular way, then that gives us a geometric series. And what it does is it allows us to add an infinite number of numbers, but it actually gives us a finite number. So this means we can still have our, and it turns out, by the way, just to be clear, that this world that we're in, where we are in between 0 and 1, 0 inclusive, is still consistent with our infinite horizons and our stationarity over preferences. So we can add things together and be consistent with those assumptions we were making before, or we can do discounted rewards, and we're still going to be consistent with what we're doing before. But the difference between this case and this case is that by doing the discount, we get to add infinite sequences and still get something finite. The intuition here is that since if gamma is less than 1, then eventually as you raise it to a power, it will basically become 0. I mean, that's why it's a geometric series, which is like having a finite horizon. But that horizon is always the same finite distance away, no matter where you are in time, which means it's effectively infinite or unbounded, or however you want to think about it.
So it's like you take a step, but you're no closer than when you started.
Right. So what does that mean in a world where you meant to say you're no closer to where you were trying to end up? So that means that even though you've taken a step forward, the horizon sort of remains a fixed distance away from where you are.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it means to to have this kind of this gamma value here. And so you can still treat it as if it's always going to be infinite, even though it gives you a finite value, and that gives you your stationarity. So does that make sense? I mean, that's sort of the intuition that you really are having, you're always an infinite, it's always infinity, but the gamma value means that at any given point in time, you only really have to think about what amounts to a finite distance. You never get closer to the horizon, even though you're always taking steps towards it. But there still is a horizon that you can see, if I can kill that analogy.
So can you explain to me why it has this form, this R max over 1 minus gamma?
I could. You can kind of prove that in a little cute math way, and I'm happy to take that diversion if you want.
Yeah, I think so. Okay. I mean, unless you were going to tell me something else.
Well, how about I tell you something else, and then I take that diversion?
Okay.
Okay, so here's something else. In the beginning, I said, this is like going an infinite amount of distance in finite time, which you rebelled against. And my explanation is more about how infinity looks finite, which is not the same thing as going an infinite amount of distance in finite time. The reason I said that is because of the singularity.
What?
The singularity. So some of our listeners no doubt have heard of the singularity. Have you never heard of the singularity?
The singularity is like when computers get so fast that you can do infinite computation in,
Right. So the singularity, for those of you who don't know, is this sort of observation that has been made by many folks that the sort of limit to computer power growing faster is the fact that it takes some amount of time to design the next generation of computers, right? So Moore's law says everything doubles, every 18 months or whatever. But if we could design things faster, then we could actually make it double more quickly. So one day we'll get to the point where the computer, which I will draw here like that, the computer can actually design the next generation of computer. Well, when it designs the next generation of computer, that computer will also have the ability to design the next generation of computer, but it will be able to design it twice as fast. And then the next one will be able to design its successor twice as fast, and so on and so forth. So this little time between generations will keep halving every single time, which looks remarkably like a geometric sequence. And so once we reach this point where the computer can actually design its successor, we will then be able to do an infinite number of successors in finite time. And that's when the world comes to an end, and that's what's called the singularity, because we can't understand what happens after that point. So that's what I mean by going an infinite amount of distance in finite time.
It just doesn't seem like distance, but yeah, that's a weird example.
I think it makes sense.
An infinite number of doublings in it. Yeah, no.
Well, we'll do some assignment where we allow people to decide whether this makes sense or one of your analogies makes sense. And I'll just remind the listener that I'm the one who'll be assigning final grades. Okay, so with that, let's go and do your little diversion, and then we'll come back to doing a whole lot of math. So I actually think this little nice diversion will be a warm-up to all the math we're going to be doing. Okay?
Ooh, warm math.